viewers, welcome to my YouTube channel, Unique Guide for English. I am Mithun Samant, an English teacher. Today, I would like to discuss the part 2 of joining in simple sentence. The next technique of joining in simple sentence is by using an adverb. Means here, I shall discuss how we can join two or more sentences into a single sentence by using this technique, and the sentence will be simple sentence. This technique, as I told already, it is by using an adverb. First of all, what is adverb? Adverb means the words which tell something about the verb, or an adverb or an adjective. Here, by using an adverb, we shall join two sentences. You see, I began to run. My speed was slow. I have joined these two sentences. I have given this answer here. I began to run slowly. So, slow is the adjective, and here slowly, it is the adverb. Another example I have given here, that is, he was driving the car. The speed of the car was too much. He was driving the car. The speed of the car was too much. Here you see, the answer, he was driving the car speedily. He was driving the car speedily. So, speedily is the adverb. In the first sentence, slowly is the adverb. And in the two sentences, we can see one subject, one finite verb. In the first sentence, I is the one subject and begin, it is the one finite verb. Means it is simple sentence. In the second sentence, was is the finite verb and he is the subject. Means it is simple sentence. Hence, here we understand that by using an adverb also, in some cases we can join two or more sentences into a single one. Another technique of joining in simple sentence, that is by using noun in apposition. Apposition means here, by the use of a comma, we shall omit one finite verb. You see, I have given one example. Jesus preached a religion of love and forgiveness. Jesus preached a religion of love and forgiveness. He was the son of a carpenter. Jesus, comma, son of a carpenter. In the second sentence, you see, he was the son of a carpenter. Was here. And this was is being omitted here by the use of a comma. This technique is called in apposition. Jesus, comma, son of a carpenter, comma, preached a religion of love. Here in the new sentence that has come by the joining of two sentences, that is, Jesus, son of a carpenter, preached the religion of love. In this sentence, Jesus is the subject, preached, it is the finite verb. One subject, one finite verb. Means it is simple sentence. In example number B, Raja Ram Mohan fought for social reform in India. He was a man of progressive views. Raja Ram Mohan fought for social reform in India. He was a man of progressive views. Raja Ram Mohan, a man of progressive views, fought for social reform. Raja Ram Mohan, after Raja Ram Mohan, I have given comma, and by giving this comma, I have omitted one verb, that is was verb. Raja Ram Mohan, comma, a man of progressive views, fought for social reform. One subject, that is Raja Ram Mohan, one verb, that is fought, means it is simple sentence. Next example along with the technique by which we can join two sentences into a single one, and the sentence will be simple. That is, by using preposition with a noun or gerund. First of all, I would like to discuss before you what is gerund. Actually, gerund is a kind of verbal noun. Gerund is a kind of verbal noun. Mainly in the case of gerund, what we do, we add ing with the main form of the verb and it acts like a noun. Sometimes a preposition is used before a gerund, and thereby we can join two or more sentences, and the new sentence that will come from the joining, that is simple sentence. You see, he was extremely intelligent. He is also highly industrious. Besides being extremely intelligent, he is highly industrious. Besides being, here is the preposition, and besides is the preposition, and being, here is the gerund. He is the verb, he is the subject. So in this sentence, one subject, that is he, is the finite verb. And here, besides preposition and being, here is the gerund. And it is simple sentence. I have given another example. Look at the board. Another example. We learned about his victory. We were overjoyed. On learning about his victory, we were overjoyed. On learning, on is the preposition, learning is the gerund here. It is working like a noun. On learning about his victory, we were overjoyed. We were overjoyed. We is the subject, where is the verb? So here, one subject, one finite verb, it is also simple sentence. So, viewers, I have discussed before you different types of technique in the case of joining. By following these techniques, we can join two or more sentences, and the sentence will be simple one. Here, actually, in this case of joining, I have not used any kind of process of joining in complex sentence. Actually, why we should learn this technique separately? If we learn this technique separately, our writing standard will be smart enough, and if our writing standard becomes smart, that will attract the attention of other readers. So, I would like to revise again, make you remember all the processes one by one. At first, I discussed by using present participle, then by using past participle, by using perfect participle, then by using infinitive, then by using nominative absolute, then by using adverb, then by using gerund, then by using apposition. All these techniques I have used in the case of joining. So, viewers, if you follow this technique, as well as if you study your books properly related to joining in simple sentence, you will learn a lot. This is all for today. I shall meet you in the next class. Till then, take care of yourselves. Thank you for listening.